All right, Jeremy, it's all you.
Yeah. Thank you. All right, cool. So Culture IQ, my topic is the intersection of culture and technology, which is obviously kind of appropriate. We are a culture platform. So I'm going to talk a little bit, I'm not going to dive too deep into what the platform is itself, but talk about a little bit about how we think about culture and what culture is. So I'll dive right in. Right, so starting out at the top, right, what is culture? One of the questions we get pretty frequently, actually, is how can I get a culture? And that is the wrong question, because you have one. You always have one, and it's kind of an interesting starting point for us. So what is culture? It's simply how things get done in the organization. We look at it as behaviors, we look at it as interactions between people, and kind of the general way that things happen, how people talk, how people interact, and so on. So we definitely don't like it when culture is compared to ping pong tables and beer on tap and stuff like that. It's great to have perks, that's a strong part of culture, but that's not what culture is, that's not how we look at culture. So why, I'm just gonna stand back here, it's easier. So why even think about culture, right? So generally, strong culture, we equate it pretty directly to a high level of engagement. High engagement is just generally better for the business kind of across the board. Higher levels of engagement help recruiting, retention, performance, and general business outcomes. So as we look at culture and we correlate culture to engagement to people, we look at the metrics, that's kind of one of the things that we're kind of most interested in, is how are these things impacting the organization as a whole. We don't like to think of it as a vacuum. And I think that's one of the things that's kind of come, that's bubbling up, which is it's great to know about culture, it's great to learn about what culture means, and think about it and talk about it, but we have to correlate that back to the actual business outcomes. So how do we do that? Well, at Culture IQ, we have a framework for understanding culture, a process for strengthening it, and then we use technology to enable the framework and the process. So if we think about the framework at the highest level, what we want to do is take what we consider a high performance culture and break that down into the qualities that are common to those organizations. So things like collaboration, communication, agility, and so on and so forth, and I'll dive into that. Take a process, so broadly our process being collect feedback, understand what that feedback means, and then most importantly, and generally most left out, respond to the feedback. So that's really the part that we're most interested in, because we feel like collecting feedback and understanding the feedback as this area of study evolves will become kind of table stakes. It's going to be fairly common to be able to say, hey, there's a bunch of different frameworks we can use, we can understand our culture in a bunch of different ways, but taking that information, being able to process it, understand it, and respond to it is really the key to strengthening it. And at the end of the day, because stronger cultures generally equals higher engagement, generally equals better recruiting, retention, business outcomes, that's kind of what we're driving towards. So Culture IQ has built a technology platform. Here's a framework. So the framework we use is a framework for 10 qualities common to high performance organizations. We did a meta study and kind of came to these. This is not the only way to look at it. There's a lot of different frameworks out there, and a lot of them are very valid. This is ours. We see that organizations that are strong in these qualities tend to outperform the market, tend to have more engaged employees. So what is our platform? We don't think that you can strengthen culture simply through technology. So we take software, the software being the ability to take our framework and our process and implement it in your organization to collect feedback, to contextualize that feedback against the qualities that I just showed, and then use our process to implement programs and initiatives in response to the things you've learned. We have a strategy group, because we think people and the human interaction is fundamentally important. So we help the organizations that we're working with take the data that they've collected, take the analysis that we've helped them with, and again, figure out kind of what that means in the context of their organization and what they can do next. And then community. Community is fundamentally important to what we're doing, and it's really kind of that third part of the tripod here, so that organizations are not working in a vacuum, whether it's benchmarking their data or collaborating with other people who are in the HR space. We feel it's fundamentally important to connect them. We use technology to do that. So this is kind of our platform and how we look at culture and the approach that we're taking. Again, we don't believe that our approach is the only approach or necessarily the absolutely right approach. It's our approach, and it seems to work for the organization that we work with. So what are we driving towards in the end? Positive measurable changes. The operative word here being measurable. And what Culture IQ and what I, as the head of product at Culture IQ, am ultimately driving towards is helping an organization get past the kind of initial segment of, hey, we've got to collect feedback, we have to understand what that feedback means, we have to contextualize that feedback, and get to this point, which is we have to respond to that feedback, and then we have to measure the efficacy of the things that we're doing, we have to measure the impact of the things we're doing in terms of the underlying culture qualities that we're looking at. And when we are able to do this, when we're able to use technology to do this, we can help organizations look at culture the same way that a marketer looks at marketing. We can help them say, okay, we want to try new programs, try new initiatives, measure the efficacy, measure the impact, measure the outcome of those programs and initiatives, and see how the impact, see what the impact is on our culture. And what we have adopted at Culture IQ, we use our method and our philosophy internally, is a concept of culture agility. The idea being, you can't just fix your culture. You can't do a hard right and say, okay, we're going this way, and people are not, and they're not engaged, they're not happy to be here, and we gotta just fix it. What you can do is a bunch of small little changes, a bunch of small little things that ideally you can measure, and then over time we'll add up to a stronger culture. It's kind of our philosophy, that's what the product is that we're building to help enable the process. Thank you for your time. I'm happy afterwards to talk more about this stuff. Thanks.
Questions to Jeremy?
Yep.
Can you describe who is your target user for the culture
platform? Within the company? It's dependent on the company. I mean, we have companies as small as 40 or 50 employees and as big as tens of thousands. Obviously, very different approach to these companies, but we kind of span the gamut. For larger organizations, we're working with the HR organization. Smaller ones, usually the executive team or the founder. Questions?
Yeah. Particularly for the larger organizations, do you see that companies are applying your technology and different strategies in different parts of their organization based on whether culture varies?
Ideally, it's especially for a larger organization, you have to have a culture. The culture is going to vary by function, it's going to vary by location, it's going to vary by team leader. So ideally, they're getting a sense of the organizational culture at the high level, and then they're able to segment it out and break it down into much smaller groups. We think that culture change is both a top-down and a bottom-up process. That bottom-up process has to come from smaller segments. If you have an organization with 10,000 employees, it's just absolutely impossible to do much unless you start to break it down. Yeah.
So, are you actually making recommendations towards change?
Yeah, it's a tough question. Yes and no. So our strategy group will kind of work with you to arrive at maybe some initiatives. We have a library of initiatives that we can kind of point you towards. I don't believe today, as it stands, technology can say to, can just recommend, hey, this is the initiative that you should do based on your intentions. But we work with the companies. Ideally, what we're doing is segmenting it and saying, okay, up front, we want to help you get to a point where you have an area of focus. Ideally, one quality or quality depending on the segment of the organization. So maybe it's communication, maybe it's agility, something like that. Then working with you to figure out, hey, what are some of the programs or initiatives that we can do to implement? And then the kind of the ultimate point that we want to get to is measuring the efficacy of the things you're doing. Because you're not going to get it right on the first try. It's just like anything. It's crazy to say, hey, we know what we're going to do, and we're going to make this change, and we're going to have a massive investment across the entire organization to do this big culture change initiative. and think that we're going to get it right on the first try. You'll get it right, but ideally it's a process. It's a process of slow iterations or ongoing iterations. And that's kind of what we want to facilitate.
Actually, I want to piggyback on the question. Yeah. So do you think that over time we'll have precedents to recommend? So the data that you're collecting from these organizations over time, are cultures too dissimilar to make data-driven decisions in the future, or do you think that's somewhat worth it?
That's an interesting question. That's the goal. Whether or not it's doable is kind of, we can make recommendations. There are certain things that are kind of like a panacea for culture, right? Like, you clearly should be, having some sort of full population meetings at some point, no matter the size of the organization, CEO should be getting up, even if it's on video, and just talking to the company and having presence. Like, there's small things that can happen that are good kind of across the board. We look at culture in two dimensions. So we look at something we call operational culture, meaning those are the qualities that end up on board. These are things that are objectively good regardless of what type of organization you are. And then we look on the other side at something called strategic culture. Strategic culture is going to be organization specific, and we're going to tailor it to the organization depending on their kind of strategic goals and business goals. So the answer to your question is yes, no, maybe. I hope that's kind of what we're trying to drive towards.
Thanks. Yeah.
And Eric, question. So to tie back to the kind of topic, which is the employee life cycle.
Yeah.
So the particular framework that you guys have chosen and researched into, why do you think it's the kind of framework that makes sense? Applying in part of the employee life cycle, just for some, just like from people that are established teams and work together.
Yeah, so we made a conscious decision to look at culture at the organization and not necessarily coming into the organization. I think there's a really interesting space when you're looking at culture, culture fit with an organization in terms of the recruiting space. That is, I don't want to say it's an easier problem, it's just as difficult, but it's a fundamentally different problem. So what we're looking at is the state of the organization itself, and the reason that we feel like it's a really important kind of component, we don't really segment it based on employee life cycle, right? So regardless of where the employee is in their life cycle, we're looking at the organization as kind of a whole, or mostly groups within the organization, because we want to be able to shift the current state. We want to say, hey, here's your current state, what's your ideal state based on your business needs, based on the people you have, based on the people you're trying to recruit, and kind of move there. But we consciously don't really touch the recruiting process because it's just a different beast. Anything else?
Okay.
Cool. Thank you
so much, Jeremy.